business thing. Man, this thing is cool. And this is yours.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Electric conversion. Casey,
yeah. It's an electric conversion. So yeah. This was an old Harley Davidson, Amarachi.
Yeah, it was a Harley 50 or 60 Mach-E M50 or M65.
Yeah.
And I went ahead and converted it to electric. It was it's sitting around for a long time, so I just went ahead and did the rebuild, bring it back to life.
Yeah.
Got the kit online, battery. 1,000 watt, 48 volt.
Yeah.
Just plug it in and keep going. But I converted it in a way to where I can revert back to the original engine.
To the original engine, yeah.
So
yeah.
There's no like permanent.
Wow. You know. Well, that was nice, wasn't it? You don't have to.
Yeah.
Wow. And you still have the motor for this?
Yeah. I have all the original parts. Yeah.
This was your dad's bike?
Yeah, this was my father's bike when he was younger, so I thought I'd bring it back to life.
Bring it back modernized, huh?
Keep it going.
Yeah, man. That is really cool. How fast does it go?
I go about 30.
Yeah.
So it's a good street cruiser just to get me from one place to the next around the neighborhood. So.
Well, that's probably about what the old 50 did at most when it was, with the electric, with the gas motor.
Yeah.
It's probably about all as fast as these things, but they might not even gone that fast.
Yeah, I think all the production ones can't go over like 25 anyway. So.
Yeah, well, this is really cool. How long did it take you to put this thing together?
It was mainly just waiting for the parts, I just sanded the frame down, painted it, and custom handlebars, custom headlight, custom battery, custom motor.
That is really
got some new tires.
That is
all the original parts are still at home, but there it is.
How's it stop?
It stops actually very well.
Yeah. The little drum brake in there.
The drum rear brake.
Yeah.
And then I got the front brake and the front's still functional.
Wow.
So it's all still functional.
Yeah. How long can you ride before you have to charge it?
I mean, it's hard to say. I haven't really calculated it, but I'll ride it for the week. I live local, so I'm just here in the neighborhood, and I just ride it around for an hour or so every day, and I don't let it drain all the way until it's dead. So.
Wow. That is pretty darn cool. I bet you get a lot of attention. Hey, thanks a lot, Casey.
Yeah.
And this is a really cool machine, man.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Modern and vintage.
Absolutely.
Very cool. All right.
Taking a little ride on the Softail now, and I'm going to go out my side of town, out in the country out here, out towards Kerman, California. There's a little bike and car show out here, a little open air event, and I decided I'd ride out and check it out. It's only 10 minutes at most from my house the other direction, west of where I live. I live out west of the city of Fresno, so a lot of stuff that happens in the city, I got to travel east. But today we're traveling west, out to the country, and it's a little car and bike show. I forget the name of the event. I just saw a flyer for it a couple of days ago. A buddy of mine sent me a instant message through Facebook and said, "Are you going to this?" And I'm thinking, wow, why not? There's a lot of things going on today. I thought this would be a good event to go to because it's west and it's not far from my house. I don't know how big it's going to be. There's also a huge car show today in Fresno in the Tower District. which I may be able to cruise over there and take a little video of some of the cars over there, because also today in Fresno's Tower District, which is a district of town, kind of an arts and culture district of Fresno, an event called the Porch Fest. People are opening up their porches to live music, and then folks get to go walk around, check out live music on people's porches. And I happen to be performing on a porch. Hey, there's where I went to high school, Central High School, way out here in the country. Looks a little different than when I was here. Yep. All right. Some bikes there. Uh-oh, that don't look too much fun. All right, we're here, finally.
Well, we're here at the Glenn Rudolph Auto Body Open Air Car and Bike Show. So they got all kinds of stuff here. We'll see, I don't know if they got too many bikes here, but they got a few, and they got some cars, and they got some stuff going on, and it's a happening. So it's a happening, and we're here. So we're gonna make it happen for you. All right, so let's do this. First thing we're gonna see right here is a 50s Buick. Oh man. 55. I used to have a reoccurring dream when I was a kid about a Buick like this. And red and white. I always figured I'd own one someday, but yeah, probably not at this point. Here we go. That's some pretty cool stuff here. Looks like mostly cars. I got some bikes over there. Let's see what they got over there. Oh, there's a nice Bel Air. 55, 56. 55 Bel Air, 56 Bel Air. 55, yep. Nice. This is one of those cars that was a classic as soon as they made it. Into my old buddy Eric over here. Eric, say hi.
Hello, hello.
And his buddy Mike over here.
Hello.
Yeah. And Eric, you don't do motorcycles, do you?
I've got a 54 Ariel Square 4.
Okay, we're gonna go to his house and see. I didn't know you had an Ariel Square.
Come on, John. I'm full of coolness.
I know it.
How many years have you known me?
30, 20? I don't know how to say.
It's been a long time.
Been a long time. Not quite 30 though, but probably over 20.
It's been over 20.
I didn't know you had an Ariel. I haven't seen this guy in a while, but he didn't bring the Ariel out today.
Nope.
Well, we're going to go look at it one of these days soon. I'm serious. I'm serious. Do you know the guy that has the two-engine Ariel?
No.
There's a guy that has a two-engine Ariel Square. It's got two Ariel Square engines in it. And it kickstart only, and it'll kickstart the first time. And when he kicks that thing, it sounds like a Chevy. I mean, it's blah, 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 blah. You know, I mean, it's
one of them sounds great. I mean, yeah. I can't imagine two of them.
Yeah, yeah. Well, here's a shameless self-promotion plug. Look on my YouTube channel. There's a I get a video about the guy with the Ariel 2 Square 2 square 4 motor aerial. So anyways, Eric's got a couple of things out here, but this is the one that I'm most intrigued by. And this is a Chrysler, a Dodge Plymouth? What is it?
It's a 1937 Plymouth.
Uh-huh, Plymouth.
It started life as a four-door car, and they cut the back end off during World War II. They made a truck out of it and called it a family farm vehicle so they could get more gas for gas rationing during World War II.
A family farm vehicle. Wow.
That's what it was considered back in the day.
Wow.
It's a 37 Plymouth.
37 Plymouth. And it's got the old six-cylinder flathead that these all of these had for years.
All original. It's got two transmissions, so it's got super low gears, so you can pull tractor implements and stuff in it.
Wow.
Pull trailers with it.
Wow.
We drive it everywhere. We drove it up here today.
Yeah. Yeah, I know these old sixes and these Dodges and Plymouths were bulletproof, man. They were bulletproof.
Yep.
They use them for industrial engines a lot too.
Yep, exactly, for forklifts and things.
Yep. Wow, man, oh man. That's pretty awesome, man. How long have you had this?
I had this for probably about 6 years. I pulled it out of a lean-to in Mariposa. It was parked there since 1967.
Wow.
I put fuel in it, I put spark plugs and wires, and fired it up.
And it started and ran.
It started.
Wow.
We've driven it, we towed it up to Bridgeport, California, and from Bridgeport we drove it up through Bodie on the dirt roads, through Bodie and over into Hawthorne, Nevada, back through Hawthorne and into Aurora, the silver mine.
Yeah.
Shut down, and then back through Bodie and then into Bridgeport. I think we put like 250 miles on it.
Wow.
We always do rod runs with these guys, and they always are impressed that this thing goes anywhere they go.
Yeah.
And it always gets more looks.
Yeah, yeah. How fast is it?
It was doing 53 miles an hour. That was the top speed until I changed the coil.
Yeah.
Then we got it up to 73 miles an hour.
Oh, wow.
Which was way too fast.
Yeah, I imagine.
55 is about the cruising speed. We drive it on the freeway.
Wow.
There's my son Jordan right there.
Hey.
He actually drove it up here today.
Now, these guys are getting too big, man.
Right?
Wow, that's pretty awesome.
And then
man.
We put the Plymouth tail lights on it. That's probably the most bitching part of the car.
Oh, wow. Look at that.
So next week, we're taking it to Viva Las Vegas.
All right.
Right?
Yeah.
We took it last year. You can see the remnants of our chaka. We were giving, we put a seat back here, and we were giving rides from the Gold Coast to the Orleans, and we're going to do it again this year.
Oh, wow.
So we'll be at Viva Las Vegas.
Wow. You going to see my buddy Big Sandy up there?
Oh, we're going to see Big Sandy.
Yeah, could tell Big Sandy
him.
John Clifton said hi.
I love Big Sandy.
Oh, yeah. You know him well?
I've met him at some of your shows and some of the other shows that he's played in Fresno.
Yeah.
While I don't know him personally, I always walk up and tell him, hey,
tell him you're a friend of mine. Me and him are good buddies. Wow, all right, man. Yeah. Hey, start it up.
Start it up? Start it up.
See what I did?
No, it does the same time.
There it goes. Oh, look at that. Boy, it's quiet, isn't it?
Oh, it's like a sewing machine.
Yeah. That's cool. Wow, that's pretty dang cool. This is pretty awesome, Eric, man.
Thanks, John.
Good to see you too, man. All right. Well, next time we see Eric, we're gonna be looking at his aerial square. We're gonna do that like in the next couple weeks.
Definitely.
All right. Here we go. All right, Eric Essman, ladies and gentlemen. All right. That's yours, huh?
Yeah, it looks really bad right now.
It looks pretty good. I know. I wonder what it looks like when it looks good, because it looks great right now.
Yeah,
What's the story on it? Is it
it's an original Arlen S
1-2-K.
And I got it up in Dublin. And I had it all the time.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
A daily ride.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, what's the motor in it?
124.
Yeah. Is it an S and S or?
S&S, yeah.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, yeah. Pretty much Arlen's floor.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Wow, it's beautiful. How's it handle and stuff? Like,
not bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's got the crazy brake forks. Handlebars.
Yeah.
But no, it's not bad.
Yeah. Yeah. It's
nitrous oxide.
Oh really? Oh man.
That model in the front.
Okay. Yeah. 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 So what happens when you hit that? Does it go?
It'll definitely. You're gonna be holding on.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I bet.
You don't want to be like you're signaling a turner and
accidentally hit the button. Yeah, I imagine it'd fly out from under you, wouldn't it? Yeah, probably burn out pretty good though, huh?
Yeah.
Smoke the tires pretty well.
Yeah, of course.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, he had fun going over railroad tracks.
Oh, I'll bet. Boy. Boy, it's fantastic. It's fantastic. Well, thanks, Glenn, for letting me look at it.
Nice talking to you.
Yeah, you bet. Cadillac. This is a 48 Cadillac. It's for sale too. Bird. duty these brake discs are. They're half inch thick. I guess you really need them to stop on this thing. Wow. That thing is huge, man. Look at how massive the fuel tank is. That thing is cool, man.
Well, all right. That was it, the Glenn Rudolph Car and Bike Show. Kind of a cool little show. Saw a few friends and saw some pretty cool stuff there. And at any rate, I had a nice ride out in the country. It's a beautiful day today. And you know, you can't beat these Central California spring days for riding motorcycles. It's just beautiful. But anyway, I think I'm gonna wrap up things now. As usual, don't forget to hit that subscribe button for me, all right? And also hit that thumbs up and the bell. And the bell's gonna let you know whenever I upload new stuff, which is every Tuesday and every Saturday on YouTube here at 9 a.m. Pacific time. And check it out. Leave some comments too. I love to hear your comments. Look at this, it's a beautiful day today. Look at that. And we're riding a Harley and we're in the wind. You can't beat it, man. All right, so thanks a lot for watching, everybody. And we're looking forward to the next video. And keep an eye out for it. And be safe, all right? Be safe. Watch out for other riders when you're driving your car. And watch out for cars. They may not see you and they may be just having a bad day. But if we all watch out for each other, we're all going to be okay. All right, that's all for today, friends. We'll see you again next time right here at the Blues Heart Biker Channel. Peace.